kidnap, rob, and then leave deserted.
Police say it's a plan a group of suspects used over and over again on Saturday night. And it's in an area where neighbors say they already are afraid to walk out at night. Police think six suspects, including a minor, played a part in all of this. Chris Sadeghi live at the Canyon Oaks Apartments with how they may have been robbing these victims. Chris?
Leslie, it sounds like anybody walking in the parking lot or out here on the street was in danger. There were four different victims who had guns pointed at their face and told to listen to instructions or else they could be killed. It can be an adventure and a nightmare living at Canyon Oaks Apartments. And for Melanie Moreno, sometimes it's a struggle to even survive.
When they touch my doorknob, I have a stun gun. I mean, that's sad that we have to live this way in this apartment.
She's got a camera sitting in her window since there's no telling what may happen in the parking lot. It didn't catch what happened on Saturday night, but word got around.
I heard about the robberies.
A man got in his truck after leaving a friend's apartment when two people, one with a gun, the other with a knife, stopped him and ordered him to drive back to this apartment building or else they said they'd kill him. From there, they beat him, robbed him, and then finally drove to a deserted road in Williamson County before leaving him. At least two other people were robbed that same night in a similar way. Moreno says she knows her neighbors and knows to stay away.
I show them really I'm not afraid of them, you know, and things like that, but it is kind of scary to have them around here all the time.
Police say victims identified Kevin Cooks as one of the men who was helping snatch, shake down, and then abandon them. But there are five other suspects, including a female juvenile that may have helped lure people here. With so much crime going on outside her front door, Moreno now thinks even calling police is a wasted effort.
All we have are crackheads walking in and out of this complex. You call the police on them, the police talk to them like they're their friends.
And police say that there were four victims, three different incidents. In each case, the victims were found stripped of their clothes in a deserted location. Now, of those six suspects, five have been arrested, and they will be facing multiple charges. We're live on the east side. Chris Sadeghi, KXAN, Austin News.